say, friends, let me tell you something about this famous film, Ben-Hur, especially the making of Ben-Hur. Friends, the making of a movie is extremely taxing. After watching for almost 3 hours in a theater, we do get the flavor of the movie, but not the aches and pains suffered by the team that brings to you the movie. Ben-Hur is a 1959 American epic historical drama film directed by William Wyler, produced by Sam Zimbalist, starring Charlton Heston as the title character. It was actually a remake of the 1925 silent film with a similar title. It was adapted from Lew Wallace's 1880 novel Ben-Hur, A Tale of Christ. Friends, I will not go to the plot of this movie as it is a famous movie, but yes, let me take you through the film production of this great all-time movie, especially the chariot race. It may not be difficult to film such scenes today because of the numerous computer aids available, but way back in 1958, it was one humongous task to accomplish. The budget of Ben-Hur was approximately $132 million. The chariot race in Ben-Hur was directed by Andrew Martin and Yakima Kanet, both filmmakers. The pageantry sequence before the race is a shot-by-shot remake of the same sequence from the 1925 silent film version. Martin and Kanet wrote 38 pages of the script, which outlined every aspect of the race, including action, stunts, and camera shots and angles. Producer Sam Zimbalist was deeply involved in the planning and shooting of the chariot sequence and the construction of the arena. The chariot arena was modeled on a historic circus in Jerusalem, covering 18 acres. It was the largest film set ever built at that time, constructed at a cost of $1 million. It took 1,000 workmen more than a year to carve the oval out of a rock quarry. The racetrack featured 1,500 long straightways and five-story high grandstands. Over 250 miles of metal tubing were used to erect the grandstands. Matte paintings created the illusion of upper stories of the grandstands and the background mountains. The production crew researched ancient Roman racetracks but were unable to determine what a historic track surface was like. The crew decided to create their own racecourse surface, one that would be hard enough to support the steel-rimmed chariot and also soft enough to not harm the horses. Even after hundreds of laps, the construction crew laid down a bed of crushed rock topped by a layer of ground lava and finally grounded yellow rock. More than 36,000 tons of sand were brought in from beaches in the Mediterranean to cover the track. Imperial Roman racecourses featured a raised 10 feet high spina, the center section, meaty columnar goalposts at each end of the spina. And then they had dolphin-shaped lap counters, the carceres, the columned building at the rear that housed the cells where horses waited prior to the race. The four statues atop the spina were 30 feet high. A chariot track identical in size was also constructed next to the main set and was used to train the horses and lay out camera shots. Planning for the chariot race took nearly a year to complete. 78 horses were bought and imported from Yugoslavia and Sicily, the largest Mediterranean island near Italy, in November 1957 that were exercised into peak physical condition and trained by Hollywood animal handler Glenn Randall to pull the quadriga, the Roman Empire chariot, which was drawn by four horses. Andalusian horses, which are pure Spanish horses, played Ben-Hur's Arabians, while the others in the chariot race were primarily Lipizzans, originating in Lipica in Slovenia. A veterinary doctor was also at call, and 20 stable boys were employed to take care for the horses and ensure they were dressed for racing each day. When a blacksmith for making horseshoes could not be found, an 18-year-old Italian boy was trained in the art of blacksmithing in order to do so. The firm of Danese brothers in Rome built 18 chariots, each weighing 900 pounds, or you could say 410 kgs. Out of that, 9 were practice chariots. So 9 were practice, 9 were for the main set. Principal cast members, stand-ins and stunt people made 100 practice laps of the arena in preparation for shooting. Because the chariot race was considered so dangerous, a 20-bed infirmary staffed by 2 doctors and 2 nurses was also built next to the set to take care of anyone injured during the shooting. Actors Charlton Heston and stephenboyd both had to learn how to drive a chariot. Heston, an experienced horseman, took daily a 3-hour lesson in chariot driving after he arrived in Rome and picked up the skill quickly. He also learned sword fighting, how to throw a javelin, camel riding and rowing. Heston was dressed with special contact lenses to prevent the grit kicked up during the race from injuring his eyes. Boyd, however, needed 4 weeks of training to feel comfortable, but not an expert at driving the quadriga. For the other charioteers, 6 actors with extensive experience with horses were flown in from Hollywood. Local actors also portrayed as charioteers. Among them were Giuseppe Tosi, who had once been the bodyguard of Victor Emmanuel III of Italy. The original shoot production schedule called for the chariot race was in the spring, when the weather was cooler for the horses and when Wyler would not be placing heavy demands on Heston and Boyd's time. But sadly, the arena surface was not ready. The arena set was not finished and the horses had not finished their training. Shooting the chariot sequence began on the same day as the principal photography. Principal photography is the phase of the film production in which the bulk of the movie is filmed. So for various reasons, once again, the film was delayed. The racecourse surface provided was so soft that it slowed down the horses, and a day of shooting was lost as the yellow rock and all but 3.5 inches crushed lava were removed. Martin and Canet filmed the entire chariot sequence with stunt doubles in long shot, edited by footage together. The footage to Zimbalist, Wyler and Heston to show them what the race should look like and to indicate where close-up shots with Heston and Boyd should go. 7,000 extras were hired to cheer in the stands. Economic conditions in Italy were poor at that time, and as shooting for the chariot scene wound down, only 1,500 extras were needed on any given day. On June 6, more than 3,000 people seeking work were turned away. The crowd rioted, throwing stones and assaulting the set's gates until police arrived and dispersed them. Dynamite charges were used to show the chariot wheels and axles splintering from the effects of Messala's barbed wheel attacks. 3 life-like dummies were placed at key points in the race to give the appearance of men being run over by the chariots. The camera used during the chariot race also presented problems. The 70mm lenses had a minimum focal point of 50 feet and the camera was mounted on a small Italian-made car so the camera crew could keep in front of the chariots. The horses, however, accelerated down the 1500-foot straightaway much faster than the car could, and the long focal length left Martin and Canet with too little time to get their shots. The production company purchased a more powerful American car, but the horses still proved to be too fast. Even with a head start, the larger American car could give the filmmakers only a few more seconds of shot time, since the horses had to be running at top speed for the best visual impact. Martin chose to film the chariot race with a smaller lens. with a much shorter minimum focal time. He also decided that the car should stay only a few feet ahead of the horses. This was highly dangerous, for if the car did not make its turns or slowed down, a deadly crash with the horses could occur. The changes, however, solved the problems the camera crew was encountering. As filming progressed, vast amounts of footage were shot for this sequence. The ratio of footage, that is raw unedited material, shot to footage used was 263:1, one of the highest ratios ever for a film. John Dunning and Ralph E. Winters edited the footage of the chariot sequence. The two editors decided that once the race was underway, one of the charioteers should be killed immediately to demonstrate to the audience that the race was a deadly one. Inserts of the sharp hook on the hub of Missala's chariot were inserted repeatedly throughout the sequence to make it obvious that his chariot was highly dangerous. As the footage was shot, it was roughly edited by Ralph Winters. If the footage was poor, the stunts didn't come off on the camera well, or coverage was lacking, then more footage should be shot. One of the most notable moments in the race came from a near-fatal accident. Joe Canet, Yakima Canet's son, did Heston's most dangerous stunts during the sequence when Judah Ben-Hur's chariot jumps over the wreckage of a chariot in its path. Ben-Hur is almost thrown out of the chariot. He hangs on and climbs back aboard to continue the race. While the jump was planned, the horses were trained to leap over the wreckage, and a telephone pole had been half buried in the earth to force the chariot to jump into the air. Stuntman Joe Canet was tossed into the air by accident. He incurred a minor chin injury. Martin wanted to keep the shot, but Zimbalist felt the footage was unusable. Martin conceived the idea of showing that Ben-Hur was able to land on and cling to the front of his chariot, then scramble back into the quadriga while the horses kept going. The long shot of Canet's accident was cut together with a close-up of Heston climbing back aboard. Constitutes one of the race's most memorable moments. Stephen Boyd did all but two of his own stunts. For the sequence where Messala is dragged beneath a chariot's horses and trampled to near death, Boyd wore a steel armor under his costume and acted out the close-up shot and a shot of him on his back, attempting to climb up into the horse's harness to escape injury. A dummy was used to obtain the trampling shot in this sequence. In all, the chariot scene took 5 weeks, spread over 3 months, to film at a total cost of $1 million and required more than 200 miles of racing to complete. Two of the $1 lakh 70mm lenses were destroyed during the filming of the close-up shots. Once the pageantry and victory parade sequences of the race were finished, Wyler did not visit the chariot race set again. Yet according to Zimbalist, Wyler said it's one of the greatest cinematic achievements he had ever seen. Wyler did not see the final cut of the chariot race until the press screening of Ben-Hur. A total of 11 lakh feet was shot for the film. According to editor John D. Dunning, the first cut of the film was 4.5 hours long. William Wyler stated that his goal was to bring the running time down to 3.5 hours. The most difficult editing decisions, according to Dunning, came during scenes that involved Jesus Christ, as these contained almost no dialogue. And most of the footage was purely reaction shots by actors. When the film was edited into its final form, it ran 213 minutes and included just 19,000 feet of film. So that was how Ben-Hur was made. Friends, we often belittle a movie that we don't like. Henceforth, before doing that, think of the hard work that has gone in the making of that film. Goodbye and see you next week.